Hey there, Fallout fans, and welcome back to another review show of Fallout 4 mods. So, it's finally happened. Nuka World is here, and I gotta tell you, it's pretty damn impressive. So much so, that is why there wasn't a video last week, because I spent way too much time playing it and ignoring my usual responsibilities. It's always the way though, isn't it? You think, right, I'll play a little Fallout for an hour, then I'll go to bed. Ooh, where does this door lead? 8 hours later, the sun's coming up, your eyes are red raw, and you smell like you've just run a marathon in a onesie. Roll the intro. So, that's right, boys and girls. Yes, Nuka World is here, the final installation for Fallout 4. And to be fair, it's pretty amazing. Bethesda wanted it to go out with a bang, and it definitely delivers. The theory currently buzzing around the internet is that Nuka World is based loosely on Disney World, albeit a very alternate dystopian future version, full of rides, attractions, and other amusement park staples. It's a massive place to explore, and there's plenty to keep you occupied for hours. So, what about mods for this new DLC? Well, it's still very early days yet, so there's not too much on the Nexus. But give it time, and I'm sure our modders are working hard to bring us some awesomeness. Aside that, check out the ones I've found to keep you entertained in the meantime. First up, a mod I've personally been waiting for quite a while. The Nuka Caller Pip-Boy by Joe Trocious. This mod does exactly what it says on the tin. It changes your Pip-Boy texture into a Nuka Caller themed version. Now, if you do spend some time searching the Nexus for Pip-Boy retextures, you'll find that there's quite a few to choose from. This one particularly fitted the bill for me, as I'm a sucker for the clean look. And the use of colours were bang on. The fun decals add to the immersion and looks awesome when used with the Nuka Girl suits. Lovely. Next up, more retextures, but this time with power armors, the T51 to be exact. Say hello to A6 add-ons T51 Nuka Caller retextures. So if you played Nuka World already, you'll know that there's two new power armors to collect. The X01 Quantum and the T5177 Nuka Original. And yes, these are pretty freaking awesome. But alternative versions are always welcome, especially when they are of such a high quality standard. A6 add-on has made 3 retextures for the power armors, the original, the Quantum, and either a sweet looking cherry version. All these are modeled on the T51 and keeps in line with the lore, considering these suits were at the height of technology back in the day. Definitely a must have for those of you who want to expand their armor collection. Right, so we have new suits to trundle about in, a new Pip-Boy to drool over. Next up, we need some new weapons. Enter Tendersoul with his Nuka Caller weapons. These things are freaking amazing. New and customized weapons designed with the Nuka World in mind. They look mental and awesome at the same time. There are 7 weapons at your disposal, ranging from the Nuka Shower, a huge weapon that can shower your foes in death, right down to the Nuka Stick, which is basically just a stick with a Nuka bottle on the end. My personal favorites are the Nuka Fist, a very powerful take on the superpower fist, and comes with its own sound effects. The Nuka Launcher, again another huge customized weapon designed on the Gatling gun that shoots Nuka Cola at an extremely high velocity. Other notable ones are the Nuka Soaker, based on the back of the radiation gun that shoots, yeah, you guessed it, sweet, sweet Nuka Cola. And the Nuka Blade, which by all accounts seems pretty damn badass, but it glitches on my game, and you can't see the blade. Meh, the rest of these weapons make up for it though, and to be fair, I do have quite a few mods running, so there could be a conflict somewhere in the mix. However, don't let this minor flaw put you off downloading this mod. It's fun and lore friendly. As a quick note, you will have to complete the main story mission to restore power back to Nuka World before you can craft these items. Once done, you can collect the secret weapon recipe from the secure Beverageia lab located below the Nuka Caller bottling plants, and then you can craft them in the chem lab. This week's fun mod of the week goes to Imegabyte for Nuka Galaxy Repaired. Why is this a fun mod, you might ask? Well, I'm sure you've already experienced the awesome Nuka Galaxy ride during your missions, but if you're anything like me, you kinda wish it looked a bit more cool. This is where Imegabyte turns the tables. He spent a lot of time meticulously repairing and updating the Galaxy ride to restore it to its former glory, while still keeping that oh so important immersion factor. Every surface was painstakingly replaced by hand, and the end result is out of this world. So I did that. Anyway, the best way to view this mod in its entirety is to get the power switched on, climb aboard, and take it for a ride. Trust me, you will not be disappointed. So, that's it for me for this week, folks. Bear in mind, all these mods do require the Nuka World DLC to work correctly. So, yeah, that's it. Have fun with these and let me know what you think in the comments below. And as always, please leave a like and subscribe so I can keep doing these videos for you. It's muchly appreciated. As for me, I'll catch you on the flip side.